साई सचरित्र चैप्टर 4। साई बाबा फर्स्ट एडवेंट इन शिरडी। मिशन ऑफ द सेंट्स, शिरडी अ होली तीर्थ। पर्सनालिटी ऑफ साई बाबा, डिक्टम ऑफ गौली बुवा, अपीयरेंस ऑफ विठल, क्षीर सागर स्टोरी, दास गनो बात इन प्रयाग, इमैक्युलेट कंसेप्शन ऑफ साई बाबा एंड हिज फर्स्ट एडवेंट इन शिरडी, थ्री वाडास। इन द लास्ट चैप्टर आई डिस्क्राइब द सर्कमस्टेंसेज विच लेड मी टू राइट सच्चरिता। Let me now describe the first advent of Sai Baba in Shirdi. Mission of the Saints. Lord Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, chapter 4:7-8, that whenever there is a decay of dharma, righteousness, and an ascendancy of unrighteousness, I manifest myself, and for the protection of the virtuous, the destruction of the vicious, and for the establishment of righteousness, I manifest myself in age after age. This is the mission of Lord and the sages and saints, who are his representatives and who appear here at proper times, help in their own way to fulfill that mission. For instance, when the twice born, i.e. the Brahmins, the Kshatriya and the Vaishya neglect their duties, and when the Shudra try to usurp the rights of the higher classes, when spiritual preceptors are not respected but humiliated, when nobody cares for religious instructions, when everybody thinks himself very learned, when people begin to partake of forbidden foods and intoxicating drinks, when under the cloak of religion, people indulge in malpractices, when people belonging to different sects fight amongst themselves, when Brahmins fail to do sandhya adoration, and the orthodox their religious practices, when yogis neglect their meditation, when people begin to think that wealth, progeny, wife are their sole concern, and thus turn away from the true path of salvation, then do saints appear and try to set matters right by their words and action. They serve us as beacon lights and show us the right path and the right way for us to follow. In this way, many saints, Visnivritti, Gyandev, Muktabai, Namdev, Gora, Gonai, Eknath, Tukaram, Narhari, Narsi Bhai, Sajan Kasai, Savta, Ramdas, and various others did appear at various times to show the right path to the people, and so presently came Sri Sai Baba of Shirdi. Shirdi, a holy Tirtha. The banks of the Godavari River in the Ahmednagar district are very fortunate, for they gave birth and refuge to many a saint, prominent amongst them being Gyaneshwar. Shirdi also falls in the Kopargav taluka of the Ahmednagar district. After crossing the Godavari River at Kopargav, one gets the way to Shirdi. When you go 3 crores, 9 miles, you come to Neemgav, from whence Shirdi is visible. Shirdi is as famous and well known as other holy places like Gangapur, Narsingavadi, Odumbar on the banks of Krishna River. As the devotee Damaji flourished in and blessed Mangalvedha, near Pandharpur, as Samarth Ramdas at Sajjangad, as Sri Narsimha Saraswati at Saraswati Wadi, so Sainath flourished at Shirdi and blessed it. Personality of Sai Baba. It is on account of Sai Baba that Shirdi grew into importance. Let us see what sort of a personage Sai Baba was. He conquered this samsar, worldly existence, which is very difficult and hard to cross. Peace or mental calm was his ornament, and he was the repository of wisdom. He was the home of Vaishnava devotees, most liberal, like Karna, amongst liberals, the quintessence of all essences. He had no love for perishable things, and was always engrossed in self-realization, which was his sole concern. He felt no pleasure in the things of this world or of the world beyond. His antarang, heart, was as clear as a mirror, and his speech always rained nectar. The rich or poor people were the same to him. He did not know or care for honor or dishonor. He was the lord of all beings. He spoke freely and mixed with all people, saw the actings and dances of notch girls and heard gajjalu songs. Still, he swerved not an inch from samadhi, mental equilibrium. The name of Allah was always on his lips. While the world awoke, he slept. And while the world slept, he was vigilant. His abdomen, inside, was as calm as the deep sea. His ashram could not be determined, nor his actions could be definitely determined, and though he sat, lived, in one place, he knew all the transactions of the world. His darbar was imposing. He told daily hundreds of stories, still he swerved not an inch from his vow of silence. He always leaned against the wall in the masjid or walked morning, noon and evening towards Lindi, Nala and Chavadi. Still he at all times abided in the self. Though a Siddha, he acted like a Sadhaka. He was meek, humble and egoless, and pleased all. Such was Sai Baba, and as Sai Baba's feet treaded the soil of Shirdi, it attained extraordinary importance. As Janneshwar elevated Alandi, Eknath did to Paithan, so Sai Baba raised Shirdi. Blessed are the grass leaves and stones of Shirdi, for they could easily kiss the holy feet of Sai Baba and take their dust on their head. Shirdi became to us, devotees, another Pandharpur, Jagannath, Dwarka, Banaras, Kashi, and Rameshwar, Badri Kedar, Nasik, Triambakeshwar, Ujjain, and Mahakaleshwar or Mahableshwar Gokarna. Contact of Sai Baba in Shirdi was like our Veda and Tantra. It quieted our samsara, world consciousness, and rendered self-realization easy. The darshana of Sri Sai was our sadhana, and talk with him removed our sins. Shampooing his legs was our bath in Triveni Prayag, and drinking the holy water of his feet destroyed our desires. To us, his commands were Vedas, and accepting, eating, his udi, sacred ashes, and prasad was all purifying. He was our Sri Krishna and Sri Rama who gave us solace, and he was our Para Brahma, absolute reality. He was himself beyond the pair of Dvandvas, opposite, never dejected nor elated. He was always engrossed in his self as existence, knowledge and bliss. Shirdi was his center, but his field of action extended far wide to Punjab, Calcutta, North India, Gujarat, Dhaka, now in Bangladesh and Konkan. Thus the fame of Sai Baba spread far and wide, and people from all parts came to take his darshan and be blessed. By mere darshan, minds of people, whether pure or impure, would become at once quiet. They got here the same sort of unparalleled joy that devotees get at Pandharpur by seeing Vithal Rakhumai. This is not an exaggeration. Consider what a devotee says in this respect. Dictum of Goli Buva. An old devotee by name Goli Buva, aged about 95 years, was a Varkari of Pandhari. He stayed 8 months at Pandharpur and 4 months, Ashadha to Kartik, July, November, on the banks of the Ganges. He had an ass with him for carrying his luggage and a disciple as his companion. Every year he made his wari or trip to Pandharpur and came to Shirdi to see Sai Baba, whom he loved most. He used to stare at Baba and say, "This is Pandharinath Vithal incarnate, the merciful lord of the poor and helpless." This Goli Buva was an old devotee of Vithoba and had made many a trip to Pandhari, and he testified that Sai Baba was real Pandharinath. Vithal himself appeared. Sai Baba was very fond of remembering and singing God's name. He always uttered Allah Malik, God is Lord, and in his presence made others sing God's name continuously, day and night, for 7 days. This is called Naam Saptah. Once he asked Kaka Sahib Dikshit to do the Naam Saptah. He replied that he would do it, provided he was assured that Vithal would appear at the end of the 7th day. Then Baba, placing his hand on his breast, assured him that certainly Vithal would appear, but that the devotee must be earnest and devout. The Danakpuri, Takore, of Thakurnath, the Pandhari of Vithal, the Dwarka of Ranchod, who is Krishna, is here, in Shirdi. One need not go far out to see Dwarka. Will Vithal come here from some outside place? He is here. Only when the devotee is bursting with love and devotion, Vithal will manifest himself here, Shirdi. After the Saptah was over, Vithal did manifest himself in the following manner. Kaka Sahib Dikshit was, as usual, sitting in meditation after the bath, and he saw Vithal in a vision. When he went at noon for Baba Darshana, Baba asked him point blank, "Did Vithal Patil come? Did you see him? He is a very truant fellow, catch him firmly, otherwise, he will escape, if you be a little inattentive." This happened in the morning, and at noon there was another Vithal Darshan. One hawker from outside came there for selling 25 or 30 pictures of Vithoba. This picture exactly tallied with the figure that appeared in Kaka Sahib vision. On seeing this and remembering Baba words, Kaka Sahib Dikshit was much surprised and delighted. He bought one picture of Vithoba and placed it in his shrine for worship. Bhagwantarao Kshir Sagar story. How fond was Baba for Vithal worship was illustrated in Bhagwantarao Kshir Sagar story. The father of Bhagwantarao was a devotee of Vithoba and used to make varis, annual trips, to Pandharpur. He also had an image of Vithoba at home, which he worshipped. After his death, the son stopped everything, the vari, the worship and Shraddha ceremony, etc. When Bhagwantarao came to Shirdi, Baba, on remembering his father, at once said, "His father was my friend, so I dragged him, the son, here. He never offered Naivedya, offering of food, and so he starved Vithal and me. So I brought him here. I shall remonstrate him now and set him to worship." Das Ganu Bath in Prayag. The Hindus think that a bath in the holy Tirtha of Prayag, where the Ganga and Yamuna meet, is very meritorious, and thousands of pilgrims go there at periodical times to have the sacred bath there. Once, Das Ganu thought that he should go to Prayag for a bath and came to Baba to get his permission for doing so. Baba replied to him, "It is not necessary to go so long. Our Prayag is here, believe me." Then wonder of wonders. When Das Ganu placed his head on Baba's feet, out came or flowed streams of Ganga, Yamuna water from both the toes of Baba. Seeing this miracle, Das Ganu was overwhelmed with feelings of love and adoration and was full of tears. Inwardly, he felt inspired, and his speech burst forth into a song in praise of Baba and his leelas. Immaculate conception of Sai Baba and his first advent in Shirdi. Nobody knew the parents, birth or birthplace of Sai Baba. Many inquiries were made, many questions were put to Baba and others regarding these items, but no satisfactory answer or information has yet been obtained. Practically, we know nothing about these matters. Namdev and Kabir were not born like ordinary mortals. They were found as infants in Mother of Pearls, Namdev being found on the bank Bhimrathi River by Gonai, and Kabir on the bank Bhagirathi River by Tamal. Similar was the case with Sai Baba. He first manifested himself as a young lad of 16 under a neem tree in Shirdi for the sake of Bhaktas. Even then he seemed to be full with the knowledge of Brahman. He had no desire for worldly objects even in dream. He kicked out Maya, and Mukti, deliverance, was serving at his feet. One old woman of Shirdi, the mother of Nana Chopadar, described him thus. "This young lad, fair, smart and very handsome, was first seen under the neem tree, seated in an asan. The people of the village were wonderstruck to see such a young lad practicing hard penance, not minding heat and cold. By day he associated with none, by night he was afraid of nobody. People were wondering and asking whence this young chap had turned up. His form and features were so beautiful that a mere look endeared him to all. He went to nobody's door, always sat near the neem tree. Outwardly he looked very young, but by his action he was really a great soul. He was the embodiment of dispassion and was an enigma to all. One day it so happened that God Khandoba possessed the body of some devotee and people began to ask him, 'Deva, God, you please inquire what blessed father's son is this lad and whence did he come?' God Khandoba asked them to bring a pickaxe and dig in a particular place. When it was dug, bricks were found underneath a flat stone. When the stone was removed, a corridor led to a cellar where cow mouth shaped structures, wooden boards, necklaces were seen. Khandoba said, 'This lad practiced penance here for 12 years. Then the people began to question the lad about this. He put them off the scent by telling them that it was his guru's place, his holy vatan, and requested them to guard it well. The people then closed the corridor as before. As Ashwatha and Odumbar trees are held sacred, Baba regarded this neem tree equally sacred and loved it most. Mahalsapti and other Shirdi devotees regard this site as the resting place, Samadhisthan, of Baba's guru and prostrate before it." Three Vada. Number 1. The site with the neem tree and surrounding space was bought by Mr. Hari Vinayak Sathe, and on this site a big building-styled Sathe's Vada was erected. This Vada was the sole resting place for pilgrims who flocked there. A platform was built round the neem tree and lofts with steps were constructed. Under the steps, there is a niche facing south and devotees sit on the platform facing north. It is believed that he who burns incense there on Thursday and Friday evenings will, by God's grace, be happy. This Vada was old and dilapidated and wanted repairs. the Sansthan has made the necessary repairs, additions and alterations now. Number 2. Then after some years, another Vada, Dikshit Vada, was constructed. Kaka Sahib Dikshit, solicitor of Bombay, had gone to England. He had injured his leg by an accident there. The injury could not be got rid of by any means. Nana Sahib Chandorkar advised him to try Sai Baba. So he saw Sai Baba in 1909 AD and requested him to cure rather the lameness of his mind than that of his leg. He was so much pleased with the darshan of Sai Baba that he decided to reside in Shirdi. So he built a vada for himself and other devotees. The foundation of this building was laid on 10-12-1912. On this day, two other important events took place. Number 1. Mr. Dada Saheb Khapade was given permission to return home, and number 2, the night aarti in Chavdi was commenced. The vada was complete and was inhabited on the Ramanvami day in 1911 AD, with due rites and formalities. Number 3, then another vada or palatial mansion was put up by the famous millionaire, Mr. Booty, of Nagpur. Lots of money was spent on this building, but the entire amount was well utilized, as Sai Baba body is resting in this vada, which is now called the Samadhi Mandir. The side of this mandir had formerly a garden, which was watered and looked after by Baba. Three vada thus sprang up, where there was none formerly. Of these, Sathai vada was most useful to all, in the early days. The story of the garden, attended to by Sai Baba with the help of Vaman Tatya, the temporary absence of Sai Baba from Shirdi, and his coming again to Shirdi with the marriage party of Chand Patil, the company of Devidas, Janakidas and Gangaghir, Baba wrestling match with Mohadi Tamboli, residence in Masjid, love of Mr. Dengale and other devotees, and other incidents will be described in the next chapter.